This episode is for all the foodies out there, especially those who also love Italy. Today, we're going on a gastronomic adventure inside the Central Market in Florence with the Divina Cucina herself, Judy Witz Francini, successful cooking instructor, cookbook author, and local Florentine. This is not going to be just another olive oil and truffle tour. Oh no, we're indulging in local delicacies you won't find on your average tourist menu.
See the dark color? This is actually spleen.
Okay.
And on the top is the sperm. They call it milk. And it's a tripe stand. A tripe is Florentine's traditional street food.
It's horse meat.
Horse meat?
Mostly in northern Italy around.
Eating boiled beef is good for sex.
Oh, this.
Mangiare il lasso fa bene al sesso.
Basil, that's the basil.
Truffles, both Umbria and Tuscany and Piemonte. We have truffles everywhere.
We're going hardcore local, Florence style.
Welcome to Italy.
Hello, this is Simone. Join me on my new adventures on the road through travel.
Volare.
Let's go!
Firenze, stanotte sei bella il manto di stelle.
Florence is famous not only for its incredible art and style, but for its legendary Tuscan food as well. And at the city's largest market, you'll find the best products from the Tuscan countryside. Part of the culinary courses offered by Divina Cucina is the food lover's walking tour of Judy's second home, the San Lorenzo Central Market, with plenty of tastings, exploring the interesting and unusual, shopping, cooking tips and ideas, and finally, lunch at a local trattoria where we'll feast on Florentine steak. What else? We met up with Judy at Hotel Baglioni, not far from the Santa Maria Novella train station, an excellent starting point for our tour, which takes us through some of Florence's off-the-tourist-path neighborhoods for a glimpse at the local life. Judy starts the tour by introducing us to some unique historic characteristics of the city she's so passionate about and has been her home for more than 25 years.
So here we are in Via San Antonino in downtown Florence, right by the Central Market. This is one of my first stops that I really love. This is where the saying BYOB came from, bring your own bottle. All the wealthy Italian families would have a villa in the countryside, would bring their products, their olive oil and their wine downtown to Florence and sell it from their villas. You would bring your empty bottle and knock on the door and the maid would open and she would bring you and sell you your wine or your olive oil from the palace. This palace is also famous for the Galileo statue above it. And now, from a private family palace, it's an art school for Canadian and American college kids. So the family stemmed the statue of Galileo, and unfortunately I don't read Latin, but you could tell his name is right there.
Yep.
So you have to walk first and then stop and look up, and you see half of the city is just hidden away.
You know what I've noticed in Florence the first time I came here? There's really not much to see on the outside, mm-hmm. but when you go inside, that's where all the beauty is. It's like they hide the beauty inside.
Well, yeah, because it was a medieval town, of course. The old city is underneath, mm-hmm. and then it was destroyed, and then the medieval city was built on top. And almost all of them have courtyards because, like, the women weren't allowed out because there were wars all the time. So the beauty of the city is on the inside. And this is one of my favorite places. Now, I know you just came from Assisi. This is a Norceria. Most of these guys came from Norcia, which is a city near Assisi, which is famous for the working of the pork. And so they have a wild boar head out here.
I Norcini venivano a Firenze.
Uh-huh. Da sempre.
Da 500.
Since the 1500s, the pork butchers who transformed fresh pork meat into prosciuttos and salami since the 1500s. They were the masters of the technique.
In Norcia, erano specializzati nella lavorazione maiale.
Sì.
E venivano a piedi.
They walked here.
Stavano I mesi invernali, 4-5 mesi.
They'd stay the 4 or 5 months because all this is done in the winter. San Antonio quale? Quando è? 10 di gennaio.
Sant'Antonio, 17 gennaio.
17th of January is St. Anthony the Abbot. We're on Via San Antonino, mm-hmm. which is maybe why they're here. And that's when you slaughter the pigs, because it's cold enough then to age prosciuttos. You can't make a prosciutto if you kill the pig in the summer, because it'll go bad. So they have what they call a sweet prosciutto and a salty prosciutto, and how much time they spend in the salt. The Parma hams are called the sweet prosciuttos because they're not as salty, and the Tuscans tend to be more salty.
Like the speck, that's salty too?
Well, that's smoked too.
That's smoked.
Quello di Parma è più dolce perché lo tengono meno sotto sale. Poi lo fanno asciugare nelle stanze apposta per evitare che prenda cattivi odori.
So he said the Parma hams are less under salt and they're put in special rooms to age. And it's the air of the hills. Allora c'è San Daniele, San Ilaria. Because in Tuscany our bread is unsalted, so ours is saltier, and you never would eat prosciutto without the bread. But in Parma, their bread has salt in it, so they don't need to be salty either.
I noticed the bread here has no salt.
Yeah.
I like it. But I think it would be good if you have the salty bread and salty prosciutto, it's too much salt.
Yeah, it's too much salt, yeah. Grazie mille, huh? Thank you.
Grazie.
Arrivederci.